which is why they suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose from the dead. Ascended into the heavens, he sits at the right hand of his Father, and he's coming again, his glory, judge the living and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. Yes, believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father.
With the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, spoke by their prophets, and in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, we confess from baptism for the remission of sins. Resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
O Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world, hear us and have mercy on us and forgive us our sins. Amen.
Son, Kyrie eleison, Lord have mercy.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, have mercy.
O Lord, Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, hear us and have mercy.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison.
Son, Kyrie eleison, have mercy, O Lord.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, hear us and have mercy.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, have mercy, O Lord.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, hear us
and have mercy. Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, Lord have mercy.
Kyrie eleison, Kyrie eleison, have mercy, O Lord. Son, Kyrie eleison, hear us and have mercy.
Mercy on us, O God, the Father, the Pontificator, O Trinity, have mercy on us, O Lord God of hosts, be with us. Hardships and tribulations, but you absolve, forgive, and remit, O God, our transgressions, those you have committed willingly, and those you have committed unwillingly, those you have committed knowingly, and those you have committed unknowingly, the hidden and the manifest. O Lord, forgive us for the sake of your holy name, which is called upon us. Let it be according to your mercy, O Lord, and not according to our sins.
O nemotai, O tayunim, O anti panagiatrias, if you name of shirin and pib no might, O web. O hirinim, O court, ye gentoim of what is web and cartulik and apostolik in a ecclesia, entef noti, amen. Arief me web shois and net out in a kihon and I door on the net out in a go in a net out in a evil hitoto. Moi noti rom beveki be evil chenefi owe. Shirin in Pib no might, O Ab Onoti in O Ot, if a smar O Ot in Jeff Noti, if you'd be Bandokrator. Tefes marot in jebif monogenis in shiris hospi Christos ben chois. Tefes marot in jebif neumait owe pen parakleton.
Agios, Athios Agios, and Ebnevati Agion Amin, Evlogitos, Kyrios, Othios, Estos, Iones Amin, Nietnos Tiro, as Moeb Choice, Maro, as Moero, Fingenile, Ostiro, Jepev Nitagro, Hriegon, O water with me and tape choice, shop shiny, Amin, Alleluia.
Behmoten tot femperif erbes nani, for one night if not if you tempen choice, open not you open sutir isos be a crest, O Jeffereske paz and egon, per voice Aaron of Ari Aaron of Shoptener of Tiaso Aaron, Fito ten of Intensha Ehri etai onotai, and so on, Mar in Tihoir of Oposent of Ari Aaron. And by a hot or a fine me hot here on tape and on, and herein in a vein and javi bando crator of choice even no. The Lord God, the Pantocrator, the Father of our Lord, God and Savior, Jesus Christ, we thank you for everything concerning everything and in everything, for you have covered us, helped us, guarded us, accepted us to yourself, spared us, supported us, and have brought us to this
رحمنا الله واعترف علينا واسمعنا ويعيننا ويقبل سؤالات وطلبات قديسيه منهم بالصلاح عنا في كل حين وان يجعلنا مستحقين اننا لم نشارك اسرار المقدسه المباركه بمغفره خطايا
Treat your goodness, O lover of mankind, grant us to complete this holy day and all the days of our life in all peace with your fear, all envy, all temptation, all the work of Satan, the counsel of wicked men that rising up of enemies hidden and manifest. Take them away from us and from all your people. And from this priestly table, from this your holy place, Jentok betak tim persishanan ihomi ejenihof nimni echili nim ejem tigom tersente bigaji.
Oh.
May your servants, ministers of the day, the archdeacon, the deacons, the clergy, and all the people, my myself, be absolved from the mouth of the old Holy Trinity, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, from the mouth when only Holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, from the mouth of the 12 apostles, from the mouth of the Holy of God, the Evangelist, St. Mark, the Holy Apostle and Martyr, the Patriarch, St. Severus, our teacher, the Scholar, St. Athanasius, Apostolic, St. Peter, the Holy Martyr, and St. John Chrysostom, St. Cyril, St. Basil, St. Gregory, from the mouth 318 assembled at Nicaea, 150 at 200 Ephesus. For the mouth of honor, Father, the High Priest Pope of Athawadros II. For the mouth of his partner in the Apostolic Liturgy, our Father, the Metropolitan of Serapion. For my own mouth, being the least, for blessed and full of glory, is your holy name, O Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, now and forever and unto the age of all ages. Amen.
Ten and nine. Jesus Christ, called to be an apostle, appointed to the gospel of God. The chapter from the second epistle of our teacher Paul to the Thessalonians, his blessings be upon us, amen. But we are bound to give thanks to God always for you, brethren, beloved by the Lord, Because God from the beginning chose you for salvation through sanctification by the Spirit and believe in the truth, to which he called you by our gospel, for the obtaining of the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, brethren, stand fast and hold the traditions which you were taught, whether by word or our epistle. Now may our Lord Jesus Christ himself and our God and Father, who has loved us and given us everlasting consolation and good hope by grace, comfort your hearts and establish you in every good work, word and work. Finally, brethren, pray for us, that the word of the Lord may have free course and be glorified, just as it is with you, and that we may be delivered from unreasonable and wicked men, for not all have faith. But the Lord is faithful, who will establish you and guard you from the evil one. And we have confidence in the Lord concerning you, both that you do and will do the things we command you. Now may the Lord direct your hearts into the love of God and into the patience of Christ. The grace of God the Father be with you all. Amen.
The Catholic Epistle from the first epistle of our teacher, St. John. His blessings be upon us, men, my beloved. Beloved, let us love one another, for love is of God, and everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. He who does not love God does not know God, for God is love. This is the love of God, which was manifested toward us, that God has sent his only begotten Son into the world, that we might live through him. And this is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the propitiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No one has seen God at any time. If we love one another, God abides in us, and his love has been perfected in us. By this we know that we abide in him, and he is in us, because he has given us his Spirit. Do not love the world, nor the things which are in the world. The world shall pass away in all its desires, but he who does the will of God shall abide forever. Amen.
Of our fathers, the apostles, their holy blessings be with us all, amen. And in Lystra, a certain man without strength in his feet was sitting, a cripple from his mother's womb who had never walked. This man heard Paul speaking. Paul, observing him intently and seeing that he had faith to be healed, said with a loud voice, "Stand up straight on your feet." And he leaped and walked. Now when the people saw that what Paul had done, they raised their voices, saying in the Lycaonian language, "The gods have come down to us in the likeness of men." And Barnabas they called Zeus, and Paul Hermes, because he was the chief speaker. Then the priest of Zeus, whose temple was in front of their city, brought oxen and garlands to the gates, intending to sacrifice with the multitudes. But when the apostles Barnabas and Paul heard this, they tore their clothes and ran in among the multitude, crying out and saying, "Men, why are you doing these things? We also are men with the same nature as you, and preach to you that you should turn from these vain things to the living God, who made the heaven, the earth, the sea, and all the things that are in them, who in bygone generations allowed all nations to walk in their own ways. Nevertheless, he did not leave himself without witness, in that he did good, gave us rain from heaven and fruitful seasons, filling our hearts with food and gladness. And with these sayings, they could scarcely restrain the multitudes from sacrificing to them. Then Jews from Antioch and Iconium came there, and having persuaded the multitudes, they stoned Paul and dragged him out of the city, supposing him to be dead. However, when the disciples gathered around him, he rose up and went into the city. And the next day he departed with Barnabas to Derbe. And when they had preached the gospel to that city and made many disciples, they returned to Lystra, Iconium, and Antioch, strengthening the souls of the disciples, exhorting them to continue in the faith and saying, "We must, through many tribulations, enter the kingdom of God." So when they had appointed elders in every church and prayed with fasting, they commended them to be to the Lord in whom they had believed. The word of the Lord shall grow, multiply, be mighty, and be confirmed in the Holy Church of God. Amen.
Yeah.
promises are fulfilled, and the saying of the forefathers are realized by the resurrection of my Lord from among the dead. Yeah.
Irene
posi.
O Master, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, who said to his saintly honored disciples and holy apostles, many prophets and righteous men have desired to see the things which you see and have not seen them, to hear the things which you hear and have not heard them. But as to you, blessed are our eyes for this, in your ears for the hear. May we be worthy to hear and act according to your holy gospel through the prayers of you, our saints.
Pray concerning the Holy Gospel.
Remember also, our Master, all those who have bidden us to remember them in our supplications and prayers, which we offer up unto you, O Lord, our God. Those who already fallen asleep, repose them. Those who are sick, heal them. For you are the life of us all, salvation of us all, the hope of us all, the healing of us all, and the resurrection of us all.
Te metavo vo Theo akosome tu agio evangelio.
Tin jevis neu chene frane psusentini gom kiri eulogesonik tokata yo anen agai ne evangelio tona nosma.
Listen to the Holy Gospel and chapter from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. May his blessings rest upon us all. Amen. From the Psalms of our teacher, David the prophet and the king, may his blessings be with us all. Amen. The Lord is my strength and song and has become my salvation. The voice of exultation and salvation is in the tabernacles of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord has wrought mightily. The right hand of the Lord has exalted me. The right hand of the Lord has wrought powerfully. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, our Lord, God, Savior, King of us all, Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, to whom is glory forever and ever. Amen. Then Jesus said to them, a little while longer the light is with you. Walk while you have the light, lest darkness overtake you. He who walks in darkness does not know where he is going. While you have the light, believe in the light, that you may become sons of light. These things Jesus spoke and departed and was hidden from them. But although he had done so many signs before them, they did not believe in him, that the word of Isaiah the prophet might be fulfilled, which he spoke, Lord, who has believed our report? And to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? Therefore they could not believe, because Isaiah said again, he has blinded their eyes and hardened their heart, lest they should see with their eyes and understand with their heart, lest they should turn so that I should heal them. These things Isaiah said when he saw his glory and spoke of him. Nevertheless, even among the rulers, many believed in him. But because of the Pharisees, they did not confess him, lest they should be put out of the synagogue, for they loved the praise of men more than the praise of God.
Then Jesus cried out and said, He who believes in me believes not in me, but in him who sent me. And he who sees me sees him who sent me. I have come as a light into the world, that whoever believes in me should not abide in darkness. And if anyone hears my words and does not believe, I do not judge him, for I did not come to judge the world, but to save the world. He who rejects me and does not receive my words has that which judges him. The word that I have spoken will judge him in the last day. For I have not spoken on my own authority, but the Father who sent me gave me a command. What I should say and what I should speak, and I know that his command is everlasting life. Therefore, whatever I speak, just as the Father has told me, so I speak.
The Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. May the Lord bestow His grace and mercy upon all of us, Amen, my beloved. As we just heard the gospel of this blessed morning from Gospel of St. John, chapter 12, our Lord Jesus Christ talking about He is the true light who came to the world. And as the Great Lent for each Sunday, there is a theme, the same thing for the Holy 50 days. The Holy 50 days had a theme for each Sunday. So this is the Sunday of the light. Do they remember what was the last Sunday? What was the theme? Living water. The one before? The bread. Okay? So for each Sunday during the Holy 50 day, there's a theme. So the theme of this Sunday is the light. Our Lord Jesus Christ is the light. So Jesus said, I have come as a light into the world, that whoever believes in me should not abide in darkness. The light and darkness cannot be the same place. If the room is dark, it's dark. When you turn on the light is present, there is no darkness. You cannot have a light and darkness inside your heart at the same time. Even your heart is enlightened or there is darkness. So today I will discuss 3 points with you regarding the light. So the first one, or the first question is, what will happen when God's light shines within us? And the second one is how we can receive this enlightenment. And the third one is, what are the warnings that those who are enlightened should heed? So the first one is, what will happen when God's light shines within us? We all are seeking that. We're supposed to have that light inside our hearts. God's light shines within us. First thing, we will be able to understand the work that God does in our lives. Sometimes we do not understand what's going on in our life or what God is doing or changing us in our life because we are not have that light in our hearts. Our eyes are closed to see the work of God in our life. And as we all know, how can we see the objects? So the light came to the object and it have a reflection in our eyes so you can see. So the light is the source of the vision. If there is no light, there is no vision. So the same thing in our spiritual life. If there is no light, we cannot see the work of God in our life. So in the book of Kings, the 2 Kings, chapter 6, verse 17, Elisha prayed and said, Lord, I pray, open his eyes that he may see. Then the Lord opened the eyes of the young man, and he saw, and behold, the mountain was full of horses and chariots of fire all around Elisha. So when Elisha's disciples said, okay, we will die, they are like around us, they will kill us. He prayed that God will open his eyes to see. And he saw like a chariot of fire around the mountain. So sometimes our eyes are closed to see the work of God in our life. And when our eyes are closed, there is no light in your life, you start to blame in God. Why you did that to me? Why you allowed that to me? I was asking for the things and you didn't give it to me. And we start to complain and complain and complain. And God is telling us, you are blind. You don't see what I'm doing. Maybe you don't understand now, but you will understand later. Sometimes God like reveal it to us. And we say, oh, thank God you didn't give me this, because if you gave me this and this, I would have this and this and this and this. But with those little small experience, God is revealing to us his work in our life to give us the trust, to trust in him. So when he is hiding his will in our life, so I say, I entrust in you. I have a trust in you. You are doing the good for me. So one of the reasons I don't understand the work of God in our life, because I have no light. So the second one, when the light will shine upon us, we will understand his commandments and the value of these commandments. In the book of Psalms, it says, open my eyes that I may see wondrous things from your law. Imagine a wondrous things from your law. How can I reveal that wondrous things? How can I understand those wondrous things if I have that light? If I'm walking in the light, if my eyes is enlightened with that light. Sometimes we read the Bible every day, because my father of confession told me I have to read the Bible every day, read one chapter. But I read it like was careless. Just read. What did you gain? Did you ask God to open your heart and your eyes to see the wondrous and the law of God? Or just I'm reading, just because I want to read. I want to fulfill, I want to obey my father of confession, because he told me, if you want to be a good Christian, you have to read the Bible every day. But what are you gaining from the readings? But do you see or understand those commandments or no? Sometimes we really don't understand. When I don't understand the Bible, it's okay, fine. So what are you doing to understand this? Are you going to read the interpretation of those verses to understand? We insist to take something as Jacob in his fight with God. I'm not going to let you go unless you bless me. It should be this thing should be the same relationship with the Bible. I'm not going to leave my Bible until you bless me with something. I need to take something. I need to understand something. You wouldn't be able to take that blessings if you don't have that light in your heart. The third point, we will be delighted in the hope of our calling and the glory of the inheritance that is prepared for us. We are called to be the children of the Lord. Correct? We are called to inherit the heaven. We are called for those things. You will not be able to understand it unless you are enlightened with that light. The book of Ephesians, or the epistle of Ephesians, chapter 1, verse 18, it says, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling, what are the richness of the glory of his inheritance in the saints. We will not be able to imagine the glory of God in heaven for each one of us unless you are enlightened with that light. And if we understand this, we will give more attention to our spiritual life. So why are we swinging between the worldly life and the spiritual life? Why we don't give God the appropriate time or the quality time to sit and read the Bible and pray? Because we don't have that enlightenment. I'm busy with my life. I'm busy with my degree. I'm busy with my school. I'm busy with my business. I'm busy with my kids.
I'm busy. I'm giving more attention to that. But I don't have that enlightenment. I don't see my portion in heaven. The heaven doesn't come to my mind that often. And this is the difference between us and between the saints. The saints looking always up. During the ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ, he ascended before his disciples and everyone is looking up. Why? The angels told the disciples, so as he saw him just going up to heaven, he will come back from heaven. So what we're supposed to do? Always to look at heaven, like this. No matter what we're doing, we're looking down. So he might come at any time, but I'm not ready. I'm not paying attention. I don't have the enlightenment to see the glory of the inheritance. The first point, if we have that enlightenment or the light of God will shine upon us, we will be able to see ourselves clearly with the help of the Holy Spirit who dwells in us. You will be enlightened to see yourself clearly. If you miss something, you try to look for it, you have to turn on the light, correct? You cannot look for your stuff in darkness. The same thing. You will not be able to see yourself clearly away from the light of the Lord. Because the light will reveal, will make it clear for you to see yourself. If you don't live with that light, you will not be able to see yourself. You will be deceived. So for that reason, the devil is taking you away from all the sources of the light in your life. Taking you from the communion, from the Bible, from your father of confession. Why? To keep you in darkness. When you are in darkness, you will not be able to see yourself. You will not be able to see your sins. You will not repent. Why you don't see yourself? There is no light. There is no light. The last point in this question, we will accept and love one another. So the Bible said, but if we walk in the light as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. When we have a conflict between each other, we are not getting along with each other, sometimes to the extent we hate each other, it means that we don't live in light. Because I do not accept the love one another. I'm not enlightened. I live in darkness. So I don't see the love. I don't see the acceptance. But I will try to pick on those few things maybe happen with my friends in a church or a school to make an excuse for myself to be aside, to be away. That maybe hibunish. They don't like me. They don't treat me well. Maybe one person is doing this. Not the whole congregation doesn't treat you well. Maybe this person is not enlightened. But maybe the rest is like giving you a good portion of love. But I don't see this because I'm not enlightened. I'm not walking in light as him. And if I don't walk in light, I cannot see the love from one another. So, how can I receive that enlightenment? It's important. Looks like we walk in darkness and not be able to have a good judgment in our spiritual life if we don't have that enlightenment. How we can receive that enlightenment? The first one, in the sacraments. The God gave us the sacraments to give us that enlightenment. In the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 24, verse 30, it says, now it came to pass, as he sat at the table with them, that he took bread and blessed and broke it, and gave it to them. Then their eyes were opened, and they knew him. This is the disciple of Amos. When he sat down on a table and break the bread and give it to them, their eyes were opened. So every time I'm taking communion, ask God to open your eyes. Of course, we receive the enlightenment in the baptism. This is the first sacrament we receive the enlightenment. This is the enlightenment. We became the son of light. When we pray on the water, in the sacrament of baptism, we ask God to change the water and change the heart of this person and open his heart and mind to understand the richness of this great mystery. He will be the Son of Light. And in the same thing, when we're taking communion, the same thing. As Jesus broke the bread and gave to the disciple of Amos, their eyes were opened and they know him. Every time you take communion, you ask God to open your eyes. A confession. One of the most important sacrament in the church. The confession. The confession. Sometimes we go and beg the people, when will you confess, Habibi? Or sometimes me and Abuna Rafael joke, okay, I want to confess. Me as a priest, I want to confess to you. When will you come to sit down with me? I don't know why we are neglecting that sacrament. In the sacrament of confession, we wash out all our sins. This is the enlightenment. God gives a chance to be clean, to see clearly what is right, what is wrong in our life. But always the devil want to take us to the dark side, not to see what is the problem. So you can fix it, you'll be clear, close to God and take your inheritance. The second source of enlightenment is the Word of God. The Word of God enlightens our eyes. The book of Psalms said, the commandments of the Lord is pure, enlightened the eyes. Every time you read in the Bible, God will give you that enlightenment. Will open the mind of your heart and eyes and mind to understand, to be a true Christian person. To see. فَكْسَرَاجًا لِرِجْلِي كَلَامَكُ وَنُورٍ لِسَبِيلِي. He will enlighten your way so you can walk in light. You will walk in the path of righteousness. The Bible, the Word of God, is a source of light. Another important source of light, as you said, Jesus is the light. So when we always look at him, we will see, receive the enlightenment. The book of Psalms said, they looked to him and were radiant, and their faces were not ashamed. Every time, lift up your eyes and look at him. Did he teach us when you pray, have like a picture or icon of Christ before you or the cross and try to pray to see his face so he will shine with his light upon you. You will be enlightened. Every time you look at him, you will be enlightened. So the last thing, or the last question, what are the warnings that those who are enlightened should heed? We need to be careful. We need to take care. We need to keep that light. So we ought to be always watchful for holiness. We are holy. We are called to be holy. We have to watch that. We have to keep that always before our eyes. So the epistles to Hebrews, chapter 6. It says, for it is impossible for those who were once enlightened and have tasted the heavenly gift and have become partaker of the Holy Spirit and have tasted the good word of God and the power of the age to come, if they fall away, to renew them again to repentance, since they crucified again for themselves the Son of God and put him unto open shame. St. Paul is talking to us, if you are enlightened, if you receive the power of age to come, if you receive the Holy Spirit, you have to keep those things. You have to keep those precious gifts. You have to keep yourself holy. You have to work in that. Do not defile yourself with the worldly lusts. And if it happened, the repentance, the second wash, every time you do something wrong, just repent and go and confess. Do not give up. Do not let the darkness like be in your life and invade the light of your life until you became whole in darkness. We all are sinners and we are doing sins right and left, including me. So, what is the solution? To repent. Repent and confess. Go to your Father of Confession and open your heart and talk. Expose the sin. Live the life of repentance. So So you will keep the light always in your life. So we ask our Lord Jesus Christ to enlighten our hearts and mind and life, to walk always in a path of righteousness and know the richness of the heavenly inheritance. And glory be to God now forever and ever. Amen.
Suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose from the dead, according to the scriptures, ascended into the heavens. He sits at the right hand of his Father, and he's coming again in his glory, judge the living and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. Yes, we believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who the Father and Son is worshipped and glorified, spoke by the prophets, and in the holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, we confess from the Ten goshtem ol chayt, ten tiyan astasis, ten ten yerev mod, ten be ol chen ten be ol esne yo. Amen.
I have sinned, forgive me and pray for me.
Of Kestas, it
here in a and incorruption, and this which enter into the world through the envy of the devil,
You have destroyed by the life-giving manifestation of your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ. You have filled earth with heavenly peace, by which the host of angels glorify you, saying, Glory to God in the highest, peace on earth, goodwill toward men.
Pray for perfect peace, love, and all the soul's greetings.
Lord,
according to your good will, O God, fill our hearts with your peace. Cleanse us from all blemish, all guile, all hypocrisy, all craftiness, and the remembrance of vice, bearing this. And make us all worthy, our Master, to greet one another with the holy kiss, that without casting us into condemnation, we may partake of your immortal and heavenly gift in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Greet one another with the holy kiss. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, O Lord, Son of God, Jesus Christ, have mercy. Yeah, O Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God, hear us and have mercy on us. Offer in order, stand trembling, look towards the east.
The Lord be with you. Thanks to the Lord.
It is meet and right.
Meet and right, meet and right. Truly, indeed, it is meet and right. O you, the being master, Lord God of truth, being before all ages and reigning forever, who dwells in the highest and looks upon the lowly, who has created the heaven, the earth, the sea, and all that is therein, the Father of our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, by whom you have created all things visible and invisible, who is seated upon the throne of his glory and who is worshipped by all the holy powers,
you are seated
before whom stand the angels, the archangels, the principalities, the authorities, the thrones, the dominions, and the powers. You are he around whom stand the cherubim full of eyes and seraphim with six wings, praising continuously without ceasing, saying,
the cherubim worship you. And the seraphim glorify you.
holy, holy, holy indeed, O Lord, our God, who formed us, created us, and placed us in a paradise of joy when we disobeyed your commandment by the deceit of the serpent. We fell from eternal life and were exiled from the paradise of joy. You have not abandoned us to the end, but have always visited us through your holy prophets. And in the last days you manifested yourself to us who were sitting in darkness and the shadow of death. Through your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, of the Holy Spirit and of the Holy Virgin Mary. And became man and taught us the ways of salvation. He granted us the first from high through water and spirit. He made us unto himself and a simple people and sanctified us by your Holy Spirit. He loved his own who were in the world as a ransom on our behalf, giving himself up unto this which reigned over us, whereby we were bound and sold on account of our sins. He descended into Hades through the cross.
Amen. I
ascended into the heavens and sat at your right hand, O Father. He has appointed a day for recompense on which he will appear to judge the world in righteousness and give each one according to his deeds.
According to your mercy, O
Yeah. sa a neksa ji. Takti etot em bay shemshi ethmehem misti irion akti mine en as ethmele mepsi is ente Exare ex gen oik nem o You gave yourself up on your own will, and the authority alone. He took bread into your holy hands, which are without spot or blemish, blessed, and the life giving.
We believe that this is true.
Up toward heaven to you, O God, who are his Father and Master of everyone, and when he had given thanks,
Amen.
He blessed it.
Amen.
He sanctified it. And gave it to his own saintly disciples and holy apostles, saying, Take, eat of it, all of you, for this is my body, which is broken for you and for many, to be given for remission of sins. This do in remembrance of me.
This is true.
So the cup after supper, he mixed it with wine and water, and when he had given thanks,
Amen.
He blessed it,
Amen.
He sanctified it. And gave it to his own saintly disciples and holy apostles, saying, Take, drink of it, all of you, for this is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, to be given for remission of sins. This do in remembrance of me.
This is also true.
time you eat of this bread and drink of this cup, you proclaim my death, confess my resurrection, and remember me till I come.
Amen, amen, amen. Your death, O Lord, we proclaim your holy resurrection and ascension into the heavens. We confess, we praise you, we bless you, we thank you, O Lord, and we entreat with you, our God.
Therefore, as we also commemorate his holy passion, his resurrection from his ascension into the heavens, his sitting at your right hand, O Father, his second coming from the heavens, awesome and full of glory, we offer unto you your gifts from what is yours for everything concerning everything and in every
worship God in fear and trembling.
We praise you, we bless you, we serve you, we
attend. Amen.
And this bread he makes into his holy body.
I believe.
Cup also the precious blood of his new covenant.
Again I believe. Amen.
Given for remission of sins and eternal life to those who partake of him.
Amen. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy.
Make us all worthy, our Master, to partake of your holies and to the purification of our souls, bodies, and spirit, that when we become one body and one spirit, when we have a shared inheritance with all the saints who have pleased you since the beginning. Remember, O Lord, the peace of your only holy Catholic and Apostolic Church.
Lord, have mercy.
This which you have acquired yourself with the precious blood of your Christ, keep her in peace with the Orthodox bishops who are in her foremost. Remember, O Lord, our blessed or honored father, the high priest Pope Ava Tawadros II, and his partner in the apostolic liturgy, our father, the Metropolitan of Serapion.
Lord, have mercy.
And those who rightly handle the word of truth with him, grant them unto your holy church to shepherd your flock in peace. Remember, O Lord, Orthodox hegemons, priests, and deacons.
Lord, have mercy.
And all the servants and all who are in virginity and the purity of all your faithful people, remember, O Lord, to have mercy upon us all.
Have mercy upon us, O God, the Father, the Pontifical God.
Remember, O Lord, the salvation of this your holy place and every monastery of our Orthodox Father.
Lord, have mercy.
And those who dwell therein and God's faith, graciously accord with the air of heaven, the fruits of the earth, the waters of the rivers, the seeds, the herbs, the plants of the field this year.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Praise them to their measure according to your grace. Give joy to the face of the earth. May its forests be abundantly watered and its fruits be plentiful. Prepare it for sowing and harvesting. Manage our life as deemed fit. Bless the crown of the year with your goodness for the sake of the poor of your people, the widow, the orphan, the traveler, the stranger, and for the sake of all of us who entreat and seek your holy name. For the eyes of everyone wait upon you, for you give them their food in due season. Deal with us according to your goodness, O you who give food to all flesh. Fill our hearts with joy and gladness, that we too have sufficiency in everything, always may abound in every good deed.
Lord, have mercy.
Remember, O Lord, those who have brought to you this gift, those on whose behalf they have been brought, and those by whom they have been brought. Give them all the heavenly rewards.
Pray for these holy and precious gifts, our sacrifices, and those who bring them.
Lord, have
Ari kataksenev choisentek erif me we in it o aftiro et aurana kesejene beniniuti et o web. Ni patriarchis, ni profitis, ni apostolos, ni rehvios, ni evangelistis, ni martyros, ni homologitis. Nem ebneumane vene net mi tavgoke volchenef nahti. En ho o vetiet o wabit mehen o oet o emparthenus en sioni ven, ti teotokos et o apti agia mareia. Nem piagios Ioannis, pebrodromos en baptistis o en martyros, nem piagios Stephanos, pebroto diakonos o mebroto martyros, nem piagios Marcos, be apostolos et o weben evangelistis o ohem martyros. Nembe Baterasius Absevirus, Nembe Agius Kirillus, Nembe Agius Vasilius, Nembe Agius Rigorius, Nembe Newtendicus, Benishti Ava Antoni, Nembe Tmi Ava Bauli, Nembe Shamtet Owa Bava Makari, Nembe Newt Ava Ionis, Nembe Newt Ava Bishoi, Nembe Newtet Owa Ben Romeos Maximus, Nem Domitius, Nembe Ehmi Psit Martyros, Nembe Guri Ava Musi. Nimbinot Ava Bahomefutin Tikononia, Nimbinot Ava Shinoti Barshemenedritis, the Minot Ava Noferbana Horitis, the Minot Ava Samuil de Omo Logetis, and all the choir of your saints, Through whose prayers and supplications have mercy on our soul and save us for the sake of your holy name, which is called upon us.
القارون فليقول أسماء بين البطارق القديسين الذين رقدوا أربنا احنفوا سام أجمعين في فردوس النعيم ويغفر لنا خطايانا
Barakat Homol Moka Desa Fentekun Mane Amin Al Madulak Ya
souls of your servants, Baba Ava Shinoda and Amber Weiswa, your servants Tamir Suriel, Huda Mikhail Bishay, Mamdouh Habib, Medhat Yusuf, Maurice Ayed, Meher Gendi Rafat Sultan, Yusuf Sultan Ghazal Hanna, Joseph Riz, John Edward, Suzanne Khalil, Michelle Zaki, Nagib Sadiq, Subhi Sadiq, Mary Ibrahim, Meher Sadiq, Amir Ta'awi, Andrew Ta'awi, Helmi Metri, in the paradise of joy. Kiryalai Sundos, O Lord, whose souls you have taken, repose them in the paradise of joy, in the region of the living forever, in the heavenly Jerusalem, in that place. And we too, who are sojourning this place, keep us in your face, and grant us your peace unto the end.
As it was and shall be, it is from generation to
and the souls in all place, your great and holy name may be glorified, blessed and exalted, and everything honored and blessed with Jesus Christ, your beloved Son, and the Holy Spirit. Again, let us give thanks to God, the Pantocrator, the Father of our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, for he also has made us worthy now to stand in this holy place, to lift up our hands to serve his holy name. Let us also ask him to make us worthy of the communion and partaking of his divine and immortal mystery.
Holy body.
his blood.
Of his Christ, the Bontocrator, the Lord, our God.
Amen, amen. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy. If not, be bondo crator, fiotem ben choice, o ben noti, o ben sotirisos, be a Christos, fiat evoletem befestavros, of ebesiti amenti, of tastoem beniot adam. Nem nefshi recho, on epi paradiso. Himself, and through his death he abolished the power of death, and on the third day he rose from the dead.
Christ is
to Mary Magdalene and spoke with her in this manner, saying, tell my brethren to go to Galilee, and there they will see me. Michael the archangel descended from heaven and rolled the stone from the door of the tomb and proclaimed the glad tidings to the women carrying the spices, saying, Je Christos ane. Esti ek nekron
elisosane esti ek nekron
Je Christos anesti ek nekron thalatu thanaton patises Keti sentes nimasido in charisamenos. Christ is risen from the dead. Down this by this and upon those in the tombs bestowing life,
He prays into the face of his saintly disciples and holy apostles, saying, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained. Therefore, we ask you, our Master, purify us from all hypocrisy, that with a pure heart we may dare with boldness without fear to entreat you, O God, the Father, who is in the heavens, and say, Our Father.
Kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation. Through Christ Jesus our Lord.
And the Christ.
Shall have abundant. Let your grace be multiplied in abundance because of my own sins and abomination of my heart. Deprive now your people from the grace of your Holy Spirit. O God, absolve us and absolve all your people from every sin, from every curse, from every denial, from every false also, from every encounter with the heretics and heathens. O our Master, grant us the reason and power to and understand to flee unto the end from the evil deed, from the evil deed and adversity, and grant us to do what is pleasing to you at all times. And ascribe our names with all the choir of your saints in the kingdom of heavenly Jerusalem. In Christ Jesus, our Lord. Remember, Lord, the peace of your only holy Catholic and apostolic church. Remember, Lord, our Father, Metropolitan, Bishop of Avatodris the Second, his partner, Abbasav, Father Metropolitan of Asarapion, Bishop Abraham, Bishop Suriel, Bishop Kurulus. Remember, Abun Rafael. Remember, Arshi Gabriel. Remember, the sake of your people, hear them. O Lord, repose the souls of your servants who have fallen asleep in paradise of joy. Remember, O Lord, our assemblies, bless them.
Give them amen, and with your spirit and the fear of God, let us attend.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
The holy is for the holy. Blessed be the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God. The sanctification is by the Holy Spirit. Amen.
One is the Holy Father, one is the Holy Son, one is the Holy Spirit.
See
it.
Αγίων και ημετήμιων αληθινών, Ιησού Χριστού το Υιό το Θεό ημών. Αμήν. Precious body and true blood of Jesus Christ, the Son of our God. Amen.
Amen.
The body and blood of Emmanuel, our God, this is true. Amen, amen, amen. I believe and confess to the last breath that this is the life-giving flesh that your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, took from Our Lady, the Lady Fasol, the Holy Theotokos, Saint Mary. He made it one with His divinity without mingling, without confusion, without alteration. He confessed the good confession before Pontius Pilate. He gave it up for us upon the holy wood of the cross for His own and for us all. Truly I believe that His divinity parted not from His humanity for a single moment or a twinkling of an eye. Gave Him for us for salvation, remission of sins, and eternal life to those who partake of Him. I believe that this is true. Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. I believe this is true. Amen. Pray for us and for our Christian who said to us concerning them. Remember us in the house of the Lord. The peace and the love of Jesus Christ be with you all. Sing Alleluia. Pray for the worship partaking of the Immaculate and the Heavenly Holy Mystery is Lord of Mercy.
Oh,
Oh, Oh, no, no, amen. Ah.
تتكلم وانشئ مديحا بين سجام في من أتانا وتألم المسيح حصل وقرب قمك بدا
things which your God have prepared for those who love your holy name and have revealed unto small children of your church. Yes, this, O Father, pleasure before you are sent up unto your Lord. Your servants, O Lord, are serving you, entreating your holy name, and bowing down their head before your glory. Dwell in them, O Lord. Walk among them. Aid them in every good deed. Wake their heart from every earthly thought, and grant them to think and living, of what is pertaining for living, and to understand the things that are yours. Through your only begotten Son, our Lord God and Savior, Jesus Christ, unto whom we and all your people cry out, saying,
have mercy upon us, O God, our Savior.
Any frown, if you will. Smarot in Jeff, not. Monoganis in Jesus. Swap on Paraclete, I O angel of this sacrifice, flying up to the highest with this hymn and mark before the Lord our God, that he may forgive us our sins.
Let us pray to the angel, saying, glory to God in the highest, peace on earth and goodwill towards men. Amen. Amen. Amen.
We are sorry for the disturbed schedule, but next week we're going to have one liturgy starting from 8:30. Next week we have one liturgy starting from 8:30, just for next week. The 40 days commemoration for Gamil Bottle is going to be next Sunday. We had two wonderful days, Saturday and Sunday, last weekend. I saw people working hard, doing their best, donating, and helping each other. Nobody seeks his own reward, but everybody is doing his best for the sake of God's love and church. This is the main goal of the festival, is to put people to work together and give a chance for everybody to participate and do whatever he can do. The second objective may be the fundraising, and when God sees the love in the church, he blesses whatever there. So we broke the limit of the 50, and we got 53,000 net profit, net income from the festival. This is kind of a figure for us. The love and the commitment is more important for me, because God takes care of the money. Be sure, and whenever you feel loved in your church and served in your church, you will be easily giving your tithe. If you give your tithe, I will tell you thank you. And this is exactly what you did. And people donated not only their money, but their efforts and their time. I ask God to bless them, and we always thank everybody. I don't call anybody to thank, because everybody does based on the amount of efforts he can do. Some people donated 2 hours, some people donated few months, but all are accepted by God. So thank you, and keep the spirit of unity alive.